Prison.
The ultimate penitentiary is 120 years old.
Overcrowded and has more than once been the site of an inmate rebellion.
They sell down there.
And they start killing.
The walls was a world inside of a world.
About 8 or 10 are breaking.
And we had to go in there and hunt for bodies.
They're still hot. They're still
can anybody hear me?
Can you guys hear me?
Get out of there, okay, bro? You can't
tell me where the hell I'm going.
If you enter that hall, you just book it. You just get the hell out of there as fast as you can. Get out of there.
I'm Steve from Bethel Park, Pennsylvania.
Hi, I'm Ariana.
I'm Derek.
I'm 19, and I'm from La Cañada, California.
I'm 24 years old. I'm from Chicago, Illinois.
I'm Laura from Long Island, New York.
My name is Ryan, and I'm from Montclair, California.
My name is Christina. I'm from Huntington Beach, California. I don't know how I got here.
I'm about to set off an adventure of newfound knowledge into the world of the paranormal.
They told me that I was going to be going on a ghost hunt.
I think I'm going maybe in the woods, someplace a little spooky.
Somewhere outside. They told me to dress warm.
We're all going to have camera equipment attached to us, like, so that we don't have to hold it.
And there's not going to be any cameramen or cast and crew or whatever. It's just going to be us. We're the cast, 6 people, and we're the cameramen. We're going to be strapped up with the vest, and the vest is going to have a camera attached to it.
We're sleeping during the day.
Then we're going to go to some sort of computer, and this computer is going to give us these tasks.
I believe in ghosts. I believe in the paranormal and spirits and hauntings.
I personally don't think they're out there. I just think they're just head games.
I believe that our brains possess electromagnetic waves, which create certain things to happen.
Yes, I do believe in ghosts.
I'm open to it because, you know, it can't happen. It can't happen.
I was always taught that no one knows the future except for ghosts. I'm trying to stick with that. It makes my life easier.
This place is really haunted. Like, I wasn't expecting it to be really haunted.
This is real. This place has a history of being, you know, of like haunted.
I sense them. I can feel them around me.
I just don't want to piss the ghosts off, so I'm just gonna keep it cool, you know.
Hopefully, I will be able to get something documented.
Good.
Tomorrow, we'll see. We'll get it all on tape.
Hopefully, it's gonna be a fun time. See you later.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. This is way freakier than anything I imagined. Yeah.
Prisoners carve up their victims, 1986.
No inmate hung in own cell. Inmate burned in death by fellow inmate. And I was like, oh my god.
Cool. Let's see what the computer says.
Yeah, all right. Guys, on console is the computer? Oh, yeah. Right.
Okay, begin your stay by clicking on the video button above to access the video.
We're watching the video.
Welcome to the West Virginia State Penitentiary. Built in 1866, for decades it was called one of America's most violent prisons. Condemned and abandoned in 1995, It has since become known as one of the most supernaturally active areas in the country.
Yes, I'd say this is probably has had more killings on 10 acres of land than most any place in the United States.
If you died in prison, it was like your spirit was destined to just wander the hallways of the prison, never to be free.
Yeah, there's definitely something hostile down here, but it keeps moving away from me.
A really, really angry presence, and I can feel it just keeps backing away.
If there's ever a place that was haunted, this place should really be haunted.
There's definitely something in the energetic makeup of very haunted places that will wreak havoc with electrical and mechanical equipment.
And once in a while you get a howling of wind. Where that comes from, I have no idea. Because there's no wind, there's no windows, you're underground here.
This is their home. This is all they know. And we're traipsing around in here, poking around in their lives. If we do not treat them with respect, then they will get angry.
Your mission over the next 4 nights will be to determine if the prison is in fact haunted. Your investigation will take you to 6 locations in the prison where supernatural activity has been reported. You must abide by 4 key rules. 1, you must follow the instructions on this website in your investigation of each supernatural hotspot. 2, use your camera equipment to document your experiences at all times. 3, if and only if you complete both nights of the investigation, you will each be paid $3,000. 4, if you decide to quit, you'll be paid nothing, and another team member must be selected to complete your assignment. Your task tonight is to familiarize yourself with the 6 supernatural areas. The person in each spot is to remain for a minimum of 15 minutes, observing carefully for any signs of a supernatural presence and reporting their findings.
Sometimes the most effective way to begin a ghost hunt is to go into a place, sit down quietly, and tune into the energies of the place.
You will begin in the prison's north yard, site of the first 3 hotspots, the infirmary, the Alamo, and the hole. Your investigation begins now. Good luck.
Using the tarot deck, I rose to draw a card. The people with the 3 lowest cards put on their vest. They're the away team.
Oh, the person with the fourth lowest card will act as a safety. If one of the away team gets into trouble or panics, the safety person will help.
5.
All right, 14.
That's 10.
Oh, I'm 12.
I'm 10. I go.
See you later.
You.
Let me get lined up here for destinations, and then we'll go from there. Over.
Thanks, officer. Am I right?
Yeah.
Shut the door.
Yeah, hit record.
Christina, you're going to go to the north yard.
Okay, over.
I don't claim any religion, but if I were to be one, I would probably be a Catholic Celtic witch.
And you're going to stop in front of the administration building. Okay, let's do it.
Yo, girl. Pray for me. Pray for me.
Fear is something that you don't want to materialize.
I'm just preparing myself for what we're getting ready to do. Hopefully I won't be a big baby and go home.
Can you guys hear me?
Ariana, let me know when you get there. Over.
Yeah, we hear you.
Okay, you know what to do. Just explore a little bit, film a little bit, make sure your batteries and tapes are all set up.
My greatest fear, I guess, is man's greatest fear, and your fear is the unknown.
My greatest fear is definitely death. Dead people scare me, like cemeteries scare me. I don't like hospitals.
That's all. I'll get back to you in a minute, Arietta. Over.
I'm just the type of person that don't believe anything really till I really witness it myself.
All right, here we go.
The away team has 60 seconds to choose a person to go into the hole. Choose now.
Is that the hole? I think so. That was it, huh?
I'll do it. Steve, this is Derek. I'm going in, so you're talking to me now, buddy.
Send the chosen person into the hole. Tell them to explore the hole, but do not leave it. They should be ready to report what they experience. But only Derek to go into the hole. Everyone else is waiting outside. Over.
Safety is standing at the light post. Do you hear me?
Okay.
this here was the hole. The older officers told me that years ago they would take them down in here and shackle them to the wall.
It really reeks of anger and murderous intent.
Anybody that went to the hole was in danger. Anybody.
Good luck, sweetie. Dave, look at me. Are you scared?
No, I'm doing good.
And can you make me not scared?
There's no reason to be afraid, Al. We're golden. We're good. Just hanging out. It's just like hanging out anywhere.
Yeah. A prison. I'd rather... Oh, man, I don't know. I don't know what I'm talking about.
Short of execution and illegal beatings, the punishment guards imposed on inmates was the hole. You'd be thrown naked into a freezing dark room and be fed from a pig trough. Your only furniture was a bucket to piss in, and it wouldn't be emptied for days. Many inmates lost their sanity here. Over. Okay, Ryan, you need to go to the infirmary.
You know, just a little room with a bunch of beds in it. I think in the back part of it, they had some cells where they could lock people down in it.
There was a inmate that was stabbed up down in there pretty bad.
Ariana, are you okay?
I'm scared. Okay, I see the sign in front of me that says infirmary. Over.
Tell me what you see. Over.
All right, I'm walking into the infirmary now. It is very, very dark in here and very scary. Over.
Everything all right, Ariana? Everything cool with you? Over.
Yeah.
Okay, you're gonna go to the Alamo. Do you know how to get to the Alamo right now?
Oh, it's right there, I think.
The inmates call it the Alamo. And the reason it got that name is because the inmates said that it was their last stand.
They had cells back in there built, separated from everybody else. This is where Red Snyder was killed in there. And Bobby Jarvis and all of them, that's where they live back in this one little area.
If there is a devil or Satan, he's working overtime in a place like this.
Okay. I'm feeling a little jittery right now. Yes, we found it. All right, I'm in. Hold on.
Ariano, the Alamo is going to be to your right.
Oh my God, you guys. It's multi-levels.
Okay, Derek.
Open the door in front of you and enter the catacombs. Go straight through two more sets of doors. So you're going to go through two more sets of doors. Go straight in the hole until you pass a chain link fence. If you shine your light to the right, you'll see a steel barred door. Go through that door. That's the hole. Over.
Tell me when you're in there.
I am now in the hole, guys. I am in the hole. Over.
Okay, just wait there until I
tell you to do something different, okay?
Yes, sir.
I'm okay. I'm a little scared.
Listen, go in the Red Snyder's cell.
Somebody told me the blood was still all over the floor where Red Snyder got killed. Red went down there and he stabbed him four or five more times, raped him, and hung him out over the third tier and dropped him, busted his head like a pumpkin.
I'm sure that people like Red Snyder are probably still there somewhere.